from Dark the Fire, I said it to Raj Babbarji, who was my father-in-law. उन्होंने मेरे ऊपर हाथ उठाया था फिल्म में, तो मैंने उनका हाथ पकड़ के बोला था, जो आज भी हम बोल सकते हैं, औरतों को पांव की जूती समझना छोड़ दे सेठ, जिस दिन पड़ेगी तो बेभाव की पड़ेगी।
क्यों सता रही है, कहां गायब है, क्यों नहीं दिख रही है स्क्रीन पे, व्हाट, वेयर आर यू?
First of all, good afternoon, everyone. It's such a thrill to be here. It's my first appearance at a festival, and I love it amongst all you writers and all you readers. It's wonderful to be here. Now, to answer your question, ये मुझे सभी सवाल करते हैं कि आप फिल्में क्यों नहीं कर रही हैं? And to that, I want to say, nobody is giving me films, and मुझे ऐसा तो नहीं है कि संजय लीला बंसाली बोल रहे हैं मेरी रामलीला कर लो, या करण जौहर बोल रहे हैं कि स्टूडेंट ऑफ द ईयर 3 कर लो. सो देर आर नो स्क्रिप्ट्स फॉर मी एंड देर आर नो पार्ट्स फॉर मी, एंड इट्स जस्ट नॉट मी, इट्स अ लॉट ऑफ वी एक्टर्स हु आर इन द 40s, द वुमेन, द फीमेल एक्टर्स. यू सी अ लॉट ऑफ देम, आई मीन आई एम श्योर यू आर नॉट सीइंग अ लॉट ऑफ देम ऑन सिनेमा बिकॉज देर आर नो पार्ट्स. एंड ये सिर्फ बॉलीवुड में नहीं, हॉलीवुड में भी है. And Hollywood may they have found a solution. I mean, if you see Nicole Kidman and Reese Witherspoon, wo they decided to make Pretty Little Liars, and now Reese Witherspoon and Jennifer Aniston are on Apple TV, and they're making Good the Good Morning Show. They're producing it themselves. तो अब मुझे एक काम करना पड़ेगा, मुझे खुद प्रोड्यूस करना पड़ेगा और खुद
मैं एक्ट कर सकता हूँ जी.
उसके बाद पढ़ाई छूट गई.
उसके बाद तो कहाँ पढ़ाई, उसके बाद गंगा चली तो कहाँ,
सिर्फ झोला लेके राइटर बन गए.
झोला लेके राइटर बन गए और
आपकी
कहानी लिखी है अभी. यू बीन क्लोजली एसोसिएटेड विद गुलशन जी एज अ फ्रेंड, यू हैव सीन हिज जर्नी फ्रॉम बॉलीवुड टू हॉलीवुड. We would like to hear your views about this. Has never been easy as an outsider. You both have been outsiders in Bollywood, which is never easy to go out there in the big bad world of Bollywood and act there in those wonderful movies. How was first your journey, and then you witnessed Gulshan's journey from Bollywood to Hollywood?
I'll tell you about mine. My first was a commercial which I did, which is a very popular commercial, the Pepsi commercial with Aamir Khan and Aishwarya Rai, Pepsi. Aur tab itne sare channels nahi hote the. So during cricket, when that Pepsi which spends the most was flashing, I guess it was easy to you know, stand out of the crowd, and I got noticed, and I got lots of film offers from the likes of Mani Ratnam and lots of other directors. But उसके बाद I did come to Bombay. I didn't take a film straight away because तब इतना internet obviously नहीं था, exposure नहीं था, तो I didn't know what the film world was about. I just wanted to model a little bit more. I VJ'd on Channel V. तब वो top 10 आते थे ना, top 10 songs like Heatmala, so we used to VJ that.
You used to be Ritu Chaudhary.
Yeah, I used to be Ritu Chaudhary. तो मैंने वो सब किया. And तो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज, वो इनिशियली मेरी लाइफ में कोई स्ट्रगल नहीं था, और मेरा वो वीजेइंग देख के विनोद चोपड़ा जी ने भी मुझे फिल्म ऑफर करी, और फिरोज खान ने भी टू बी लॉन्च्ड विद फरदीन खान, एंड द वन दैट आई पिक्ड वाज ऑपोजिट ऑब्वियसली शाहरुख खान विद मिस्टर घाई. तो इनिशियली देयर वाज नो स्ट्रगल. सेकेंड फिल्म विच केम वाज डार्क द फायर, वो भी बहुत बड़ी सक्सेस हो गई. एंड जब मैं अपनी तीसरी फिल्म शूट कर रही थी, जिसके प्रोड्यूसर अजय देवगन थे, एंड देयर वाज अजय, मी एंड काजल, दिल है तुम्हारा, प्रकाश झा की, उस फिल्म के दौरान जब मैं शूटिंग पे जा रही थी, आई वाज गोइंग इन द कार अर्ली मॉर्निंग, विच इज़ व्हाई आई एम सो हैप्पी विद नितिन गडकरी फॉर मेकिंग दीज ट्रैफिक रूल्स सो स्ट्रॉन्ग. अ ट्रक केम एंड हिट माई कार एंड द एंटायर ग्लास वेंट इन टू माई फेस. And there was a big struggle to get me to the hospital and all of that, and then the doctor said everything is fine, and I wanted to go and get my head scan ki MRI karo, andar kuch toota hua to nahi hai, kuch clot to nahi hai. So all of that was fine, but when I saw my face in the mirror, I collapsed. You know, I've seen this scene in a movie ki you're an actor and the only thing that gets damaged is your face. And I remember when I was standing in the hospital, jab main sheeshe mein dekh rahi thi, to the whole thing just went zzzz and I fell. And jab hum filmon mein ye scene dekhte hain, to we think it's over dramatic and aise thodi hota hai, thali haath se gir gayi and all. But literally that happens. You lose, your knees don't have the strength to hold you up. And that's when my struggle began. My struggle began after 3 successful films back to back. I was laid up at home for a whole year. They were not very deep cuts, so they were just stapled together. And I was not allowed to go in the sun. So every time you get hurt, just don't go out in the sun, you'll never get a scar. Huh? So this is from the cosmetic surgeons that I'm telling you. And I didn't want to tell people that this had happened to me. And I begged Ajay Devgan, nobody should know about this because abhi to meri zindagi khatam hui hai, career khatam hua hai, there's no chance for me to get back. But if there's little hope, log bolenge re yaar uski to chehra hi kharab ho gaya, wo finished ho gaya. You know, it was like that then. Today, with social media, if this had happened to me, I would have got the support of you people. I would have become a bigger star than I was then. Which is what happens with so many of us when we are fighting demons or we are fighting an illness. There is support from society and we become stronger with the support of so many people and being in touch. But at that time, I would have been buried. And I really, really, that's why Ajay Devgan is my top favorite actor, because luckily he was my producer. He took care of that entire thing. And a year later, when I was ready to do films, people were like, oh, you gave the signing amount back, aap to film nahi kar rahe, aap to moody ho, you're very moody, you signed a film, you walked out last minute. So I had this personality trait. I was arrogant, I was moody, and I had to fight all that. And then I started doing little appearances in movies which were known as guest appearances. I did Dharkan and that did well. And then I did Tere Naam, just one song in a Salman Khan film, and that did well. And then I got back. But my biggest struggle for me and my family was in the middle of my career. And so people talk about different kinds of struggles, like going to producers and asking them for a part. But that was not my struggle. My struggle was here, where I was struggling just to go through each day and wonder whether I'll even have a normal life. And it's very easy to identify the pain of all the acid victims. I was in Gorakhpur maybe 3 weeks ago, and I met the acid victims there. And I like the work the Chief Minister is doing there. He has this Romeo Squad, and that whole, you know, acid attacks have gone down on women. And on a little filmy note, my second film had a dialogue which I'd like to say, and it is still relevant today, is, you know, with the Me Too movement and all that, things are getting better for women. At least we can speak up and we have the society to support us. We don't need to go to a police station to register a complaint. We can simply put it on social media and we can shame the person who shamed us in private.